Alright, so Esper Draw Go compared to Esper Control. Sometimes we missed Lingering Souls. I didn't really miss Tastiger. I really think Tastiger does belongs more to Grixis Control because of Culligan's Command. When Tastiger is killed, you can bring it back with Culligan's Command, whereas you cannot do that in the Esper shell. Overall, I felt more confident with Esper Draw Go than Esper Control with Souls and Tastiger. Many times, verdicts were just light out, and against aggro decks, we were far more consistent. I was not particularly amazed by Think Twice and Search of Ascenta. I mean, Search for Ascenta is great, but I didn't activate it as often as I would have liked. Often we already have some stuff to do with our mana. We have Esper Charms, Snapcaster Mage, maybe to Esper Charm again. And honestly, I don't think Search for Ascenta is as good as in other shells here. I think I still prefer a second Sphinx's Revelation. Honestly, I don't really know. The card filter ability is awesome, but once it's transformed, it's kind of worse. I think most of the time, I even would have preferred not transforming it. So I don't really know what to think about Ascenta. As far as the matchup goes, I think we were pretty stronger with this shell. We were either losing or either winning, but there was no weird space in between where we think we win, but then we lose because of a top deck, or we're losing, then we top deck something and we just stabilize. It's a more clear situation, and I really think that Esper Draw Go, if you know the timing well and if you know the matchups, the metagame, Esper Draw Go is really, really strong. I mean, we beat one Eldratron on camera, and we beat another one of recording. We lost to Storm, but we won another game. And we obviously won every game we played against Control X. We lost to a weird Teemer deck, also a Teemer Pyromancer deck with a lot of value. And Esper Control feels a little bit like Esper Draw Go. So Lingering Souls doesn't really change that thing. If your opponent is doing a lot of value and taxing his or her graveyard, generating tokens, you will have a really, really hard time dealing with this. If your opponent is playing Blood Moon, of course you have the Esper Charms, but every resource you waste on Blood Moon is resources that will not be used to deal with other stuff, and that's some sort of a problem. The ability of Esper Charm was fantastic, and having 4 makes me think that Esper Draw Go is far better than Esper Control with Lingering Souls. 25 lands felt like the right number. We never really went flooded. We were sometimes a little bit short on mana. The problem is one Field of Ruin. Sometimes it hurts because it's colorless, but sometimes you really, really want it. Of course, we cannot pretend like we're blue-white control and we don't have a land disruption plan, but I feel like having a second one might be quite good too. About the sideboard, we didn't get to play Elspeth, but it really, really, really is powerful against some matchups, and I really think it belongs to the deck. Vendilion Click were awesome. Thoughtseize were not that great in the games we played. I know by experience, because I played like 4 months exclusively Esper Draw Go, I know that Thoughtseizes are awesome against Valakut decks. It's great against Storm, of course, it's great against Tron, but we didn't really saw them early game in other matchups where it could have mattered. Ruined Halo proved to be fantastic. I'm a bit disappointed with Rest in Peace. Maybe we should play Surgical Extractions over Rest in Peace because it combos with Thoughtseize and it combos with counterspells. In the game against Living End, I would have really liked to have Surgical Extraction, and Rest in Pieces were not that great. We also played against Black-White Control, and we desperately needed Rest in Pieces. There was a game where we had 2 in our opener, and opponent went discard spell and made them throw them away. If they had been surgical extractions, we could have played them back with Snapcaster Mages. One other problem is that when you bring in Rest in Peace, you have to cut down some of your graveyard-dependent cards. So Logic Knots, Think Twice, Snapcaster Mages. With surgical extraction, there's not that kind of problem. So maybe Rest in Peace should be surgical extraction. Engineered Explosives didn't do much in the games, but I think that we didn't find the great matchup for it to shine, so that's not really a problem. So to conclude, I think that Esper Draw Go is better than Esper Control with Lingering Souls and Tasigur, but I don't really recommend playing Esper Control at your local game store or maybe in tournament. Esper Control is very good on Magic Online because you are responsible for your own time. And when you're playing in a Friday night Magic or in a tournament in Paper Magic, you waste a lot of time fetching and opponents tend to play a little bit slower. And because you're not able to close the game really quickly and because you are forcing the opponent to enter a realm he or she doesn't know, which is the late game realm, they often take very, very long to make their decision because they don't know how to play in the late game for most of them. Plus, they don't really know how to play against Esper Charm. Should I play my lands? Should I keep my cards and try to overload them? Or should I cast my cards and run into a counterspell because if I don't, they will make me discard with Esper Charm? That's a really tough situation for aggro and combo players who are not used to play against Esper Control. So because of that, you always, well, not always, but often time out. And when you time out because of you, it's not really frustrating. But when you know that you could have ended up the game and it's just because your opponent played slower than usual, it's kind of frustrating. Of course, if you win the first game and they time out, you have the victory, but once you start timing out each game, your friends and your opponent will ask you to play faster, and even though you're not forced to play faster because they ask you if you play at a decent pace, you will tend to upset people. So I don't think that risking to time out one out of two games is a real, real good bargain. So I think you should play Esper Control with Lingering Souls and Tasigur if you are planning on playing Paper Magic. But on Magic Online, because you don't have to fetch in your deck, well, because it's easier, and because you are responsible for your own times out, I think playing Esper Control might be a very, very solid strategy. So let me know what you thought of those games. Let me know if you thought Esper Control with the Lingering Souls was better than Draw Go. Let me know your opinion and let's discuss it. See you in the next videos. Bye-bye.